Caroline Gruen, who is the chair of a Friends of a War Memorial for Bramley, to welcome us here this afternoon.
Lord Mayor, Rachel Reeves MP, the Scots Guards, councillors, friends and family of Fred McNess, the churches and the community of Bramley, welcome to this very special occasion. It gives me real pleasure to personally welcome the relatives of Fred to Bramley. There are 11 direct members of the family today, and I'd like to mention particularly Mick, Christine and Barbara, Fred's grandchildren, who claim that they play a very central role in today's community. This is our very special place, created by our community, for our community. And it's a great honour for Bramley people to host your family's event here today. We are here to commemorate the award to Fred of the Victoria Cross, hard won through his extreme bravery, extraordinary determination and courage, and unremitting physical resilience. Exactly 100 years ago today, Fred was fighting in the terrible Battle of the Somme on our behalf. A Bramley-born lad that we will always continue to remember and be proud of. I hope you'll take the time to read Fred's story in the order of service, kindly compiled by me, and incorporated into the service pamphlet by John Barker and the Friends of Bramley War Memorial Committee. Fred said, "If Bramley is proud of me, then I am proud of Bramley." And I think that the spirit shown here shows that Bramley is indeed proud of Fred and proud of his achievements. And with that thought in mind, I'd like to hand you over to the Lord Mayor of Leeds. Lord Mayor.
Good afternoon and welcome. It is very humbling to see so many of you here in support of today's commemoration. To remember the bravery of the fallen, the Department of Communities and Local Government has organised provision of commemorative paving stones for the Victoria Cross awardee in Britain. Awarded the Victoria Cross between the years of 1914 and 1918. Leeds City Council has worked closely with our partners at the DCLG to ensure the suitable and sensitive placement of these stones in honour of the awardees' bravery and valour. Sergeant Fred McNess is the second of eight awardees in Leeds to be dedicated one of these stones for his extraordinary courage during World War I. Fred McNess was born in Bramley on the 22nd of January 1891 and was the youngest of four children of John and Mary McNess. He came originally from Perth in Scotland. Contrary to his Scottish descent, he spent most of his life in his town, however, and attended Bramley National School before joining the Army in 1915. During World War I, Sergeant Fred McNess showed extreme courage and leadership in the face of life-threatening conditions. In dark times, he strove to serve his country, even when he became severely injured from the brutality of war and was otherwise unable physically to do so. For that, we are eternally humbled and grateful. After the award, his Victoria Cross, Fred visited his hometown, Bramley, in July 1917 for a reception and was greeted by large crowds, much like today, and even a brass band. Post-war, in January 1920, Fred and other members of the returning forces were treated to a reception and a welcome home ceremony here again in Bramley. Today we gather here again in his hometown, in his memory, to acknowledge and commemorate him in honour. On behalf of the City of Leeds, I give our gratitude that we are able to publicly honour Fred's courage through the dedication of his stone, and I extend our thanks to those here to witness and support this special occasion today.
gather today to remember Fred McNess, one of the many who were involved in the Battle of the Somme. We honour those who endured the mud and the blood, who showed great courage and loyalty, who saw weeping and frightened faces, bodies disfigured or broken, whose minds were numbed by the noise of bombardment, for all who tended the maimed and the injured, and for those families who still hold the memories of deceased soldiers. We ask for God's mercy and for ourselves the grace to remember. Let us pray. O God, our light and our defence, breathe your gentle spirit over the wastes of our world. Protect our memories from the infection of hate, that we may live free from fear and resentment. May the light of Christ lead us out of the valley of the shadow of death onto paths of reconciliation, forgiveness, and peace. For the sake of the world, your Son came to save. Amen. I'd now like to invite Rachel Reeves, our MP, to read a poem by Charles Henry Wood, Remembrance.
Grant peace, O Lord, across our strife-torn world, where war divides and greed and dogma drive. Help us to learn the lessons from the past, that all are human and all pay the price. All life is dear and should be treated so. Joined, not divided, is the way to go. Protect, dear Lord, all who on our behalf now take the steps that place them in harm's way. May they find courage for each task they face by knowing they are in our thoughts and ways. Then duty done and missions at an end, return them safe to family and friends. Grant rest, O Lord, to those no longer with us, who died protecting us and this their land. Bring healing, Lord, to those who, through their service, bear conflict scars on body or in mind. With those who mourn, support and comfort share. Give strength to those who for hurt loved ones care. And some there be who no memorial have, who perished as though they'd never been. For our tomorrow, their today they gain, and simply ask in our hearts that this, we heed their call and pledge ourselves again. At dusk and dawn, we will remember them.
And now I invite my friend and colleague, the Reverend Godfrey Nicholson, to read to us from the Bible.
The Lord is my shepherd, therefore can I lack nothing. He shall feed me in a green pasture and lead me forth beside the waters of comfort. He shall comfort my soul and bring me forth in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou shalt prepare a table before me against them that trouble me. Thou hast anointed my head with oil, and my cup shall be full. Surely thy loving kindness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Victoria Cross citation is to be read by the Regimental Adjutant, Major James Kelly, Scots Guard.
The citation for the Victoria Cross awarded to Sergeant Fred McNess for action near Ginchy, a small village on the Somme, on the Western Front in France on the 15th of September 1916, exactly 100 years ago this very day. For most conspicuous bravery, during a severe engagement, he led his men on with the greatest dash in fierce of heavy shell and machine gun fire. When the first line of enemy trenches was reached, it was found that the left flank was exposed and that the enemy was bombing down the trench. Sergeant McNess thereupon organised a counterattack and led it in person. He was very seriously wounded in the neck and the jaw. But he went on passing through the barrage of hostile bombs in order to bring up fresh supplies of bombs to his own men. Finally, he established a block and continued encouraging his men and throwing bombs till utterly exhausted by loss of blood.
And now the commemorative stone will be unveiled by a member of Fred's family, assisted by a Scots guard.
Brigadier Ross, Major Kelly, representatives from the regiment and the association honour his memory here as the regiment has done for 100 years to Cartwright. Fred would approve, I think. Thank you for all you've done for him and for his family. We see here today members of Fred's family who haven't seen each other for a very long time. Some we've never met before. Thank you for coming together today. So many people here from his hometown, his home city, the place he couldn't wait to return to after so many months recovering from his injury. Thank you for coming today. And thank you for looking after his memory as well as you looked after him and his family. I'm your friend. Dorothy, our grandmother, and Molly, our mum, will approve. My book was into the BBC television programme Heroes of the Soul. I was asked how I felt about my grandfather and his team. My response was one of many conversations that unfortunately were following words from the illuminated address presented to him by the citizens of Bramley and of Leeds. The following. The committee desire, on behalf of the subscribers to your testimony and promise, to express their great appreciation for the gallant conduct you displayed on the 15th of September 1916, for which His Majesty the King awarded you the highest of all British honours, the Victoria Cross. The citizens of Leeds, and of our village in particular, feel proud that one so intimately connected with them upheld the noblest traditions of the British Empire, and congratulate you on the distinction so worthily won. Those words were written 100 years ago, but they still apply. However, Fred would want us to remember that although he was awarded the Victoria Cross, the recognition and the medal belong to all of those who were there with him 100 years ago today. Thank you.
Fred McNess was a quiet man, an ordinary man, who in extraordinary times did an extraordinary thing. We're not here today to glorify war or violence, but to remember the sacrifice that Land Sergeant Fred McNess made this day 100 years ago. He gave so much for King and country, and we are here to remember and honour him. May the God of peace give him rest. We ask this for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Remember, O Lord, all those who have died the death of honour and are departed in the hope of resurrection to eternal life. All who lay down their lives for the cause of freedom and justice. And especially this day, we ask this for Fred McNess. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be upon him, now and forever. For all these, may they rest in that place of light when sorrow and mourning are far banished. O Lord, the lover of men, grant this for thine only Son, Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. I now invite my friend and colleague, the Reverend Paul Greening, to lead us in the Scots Guard Collect and the Lord's Prayer.
Almighty God, whose blessed Son did say unto St. Andrew, follow me. Grant that the Scots guards who wear the cross of thy holy apostle may follow those Son with impunity, be made stronger in brotherhood, and fierce against all enemies of our Saviour, ever going forward under the leadership of him, who by the hard and painful way of the cross won high conquest in great glory. Even Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
By Rachel Reeves, Member of Parliament. On behalf of the Royal British Legion, and the poppy appeal. On behalf of the Scots Guards. And now may be wreaths laid on behalf of other organisations. So now I invite Councillor Caroline Gruen to bring some words of thanks.
I would just like an opportunity informally to say some thank yous at this point. First of all, I'd really like to thank all of the friends and family and relatives of Fred McNess for coming to Bramley for this very special occasion and for travelling so far so far and wide as they have. I'd also like to thank the Friends of Bramley War Memorial. have put this event together, and who have literally spent months already on the organisation of it. And I think you can see by the quality of the event they've put on, just how hard they've worked to bring everything together. I'd particularly like to thank and recognise the Scots Guard's contribution to this, and their respect for Fred and his achievements. And basically, thank you all for being such a fantastic attending audience and participating group on this really very special occasion. So thank you all very much indeed, and I hope we can speak informally at the end of the session.
Some words of blessing. Bring us, O Lord God, at our last awakening into the house and gate of heaven, to enter into that gate and dwell in that house where there shall be no darkness nor dazzling, but one equal light, no noise nor silence, but one equal music, no fears nor hopes, but one equal possession. No foes nor friends, but one equal communion in one equal eternity in the habitation of your glory. The national anthem. Entirely appropriate, but I feel we ought to at least sing that first verse. I think we have a note. If not, trust me, I'm the vicar.
God save our gracious Queen, long live our noble Queen, God save the Queen.
Oh, final thing, ladies and gentlemen, the Scots Guards would like to make a presentation to the Lord Mayor and the people of Leeds to represent this day. It's a framed photograph of Fred McNess, his citation, copies of all his medals, including his Victoria Cross, and a short history of Fred McNess and his family. The Lord Mayor and the Scots Guards representatives would like to come forward. Those that want to take photographs, want to do the photo opportunity.
I've just been invited to thank you once again for your attendance, and just to say that if you do wish to make your own act of remembrance, if you also would like to make some kind of commemoration, there will be a period of quiet music as we reflect once more upon the work of Fred McNess and all those people who on our behalf put themselves in great danger, and indeed, in some cases, gave their lives. Thank you once again for coming. I do hope that you will remember today and why it is that we have gathered together. Thank you.
Remember Jimmy T. Bag, James? This is because we
First of all, what, it's the lack of medals, what we won.
Yeah.
Didn't have time to win medals.
No.
My dad won a military medal in Italy in 1944.
Yeah.
But lack of medals there. Yeah. It was all dead men.
Thank you.